In this lesson, we'll look at how to add audio and sound effects. First, let's see how to add audio in CapCut. Either tap the Add Audio track under the main track or tap Audio in the toolbar below. Both options bring up the audio toolbar. First, we'll look at sounds. Tap Sounds to open CapCut's music library. The music library is split into different collections. Tap the collection that best suits your video and pick a song. For example, for our video, we'll choose the song Normal Life. If you often use the same song, tap the star icon to save it to favorites so you can find it again later. The second way to add audio is to extract it. Tap Extracted to go to your phone album, select a video that has audio, and tap the Import Sound Only button at the bottom. This will extract the audio from the video and add it as an audio track. Now, let's look at how you can trim the audio. The first way to do it is to tap the audio track, then tap Split in the bottom toolbar. Tap the part you don't want, and then tap Delete below to get rid of it. The second method is to tap and hold the two white bookends of the audio track, then move the bookends to delete the parts you don't want. After you've trimmed the audio, don't forget to line up the audio and the video. Tap and hold the middle of the audio track to move it so it lines up with the start of the video. To make the start and end of the audio seem more natural, you can fade it in and out. Tap the audio, then, in the toolbar, select Fade. Next, move the white circles to set the duration of the fade in and fade out. It works best if the fade in and fade out lasts about 1 second each. To change the volume, tap the track, then tap Volume in the toolbar below. Move the white circle left to turn the volume down or right to turn the volume up. If you want to mute the original audio for the main video track, tap Mute Audio Clip to the left of the main track. If you only want to mute the audio for a particular clip, tap the clip, tap Volume below, and then move the white circle left until the volume is zero. Now we've edited the audio, let's look at how to edit the video to match the beat of the music. If you want to edit your video faster, you can just use the Auto Match Cut feature. Select the audio track, then tap Match Cut in the bottom toolbar. Then turn on Auto Generate. We have two options now. Beat 1 adds beat markers based on the melody, and Beat 2 adds them based on the beat. Here, we'll choose Beat 2. And then tap the check mark in the bottom right corner. Back on the main editing page, we can see that the audio track now has lots of yellow dots. These are the smart beat markers that have been added. To make a beat sync video, we need to line up the scene changes in our video with these yellow dots. But you can see that there are a lot of dots. Normally, you can just use the beats as a guideline and match up the video with the graph. For example, you can line up the transition between these two clips with the high point in the graph below, which is also where the yellow dot is. This allows your video to match the rhythm. Next, we can do the same for the rest of the clips. Now our video matches the music. We can also add some audio effects based on what is happening in the video. This helps create a layered effect. For example, for this image of the sea, we can add the sound of waves. Tap Audio, and then select Effects. CapCut comes with a variety of sound effects to choose from. Find this Waves effect, and tap it to add it to your timeline. Let's see the result. It sounds better with the waves, right? Now we've added audio and sound effects. Next, let's look at how to add a voiceover. First, you can record your own voice. Tap Audio in the toolbar, then tap Voiceover. Now, you can see the recording page. Tap and hold the microphone to start recording, and let go to stop recording. Once you're done, tap the check mark, and then you'll see your voiceover in the timeline. If you tap the voiceover track, you can select Voice Effects at the bottom to change your voice. Aside from recording your voice, you can also use text-to-speech to generate a voiceover. Tap the text button in the bottom toolbar, then select Add Text. Add some text, Then tap the track of the text you just added. In the toolbar, you'll see the option Text to Speech. Tap that, and you can see different voice options. Select the voice you like best. In this lesson, we've looked at how to add and work with audio. Next time, we'll look at how to add captions and stickers. See you then!